He's gonna play Granny. I'm back again.
Oh.
I'm back again, y'all. So, let's have some fun. We all know she moves a bit slower. It don't smell like fish no more. That's good. Well, when you actually run from Granny, it gets a little bit scary. She's not in here right now, so we're good. No, crap. Oh no, this is bad, y'all. Well, she right there. Derek House, the Clay Michael of free throw. Cleveland's got to hurry. J.R. Smith has got it. He's going to take the shot from about 38 feet. No, sir. Indiana's going to wait, so let's take a closer look at that. Court. Jordan Clarkson is wide open. LeBron James sealing off a defender to keep him from getting there. Quickest second spot. Clarkson had a 4% chance to make the shot. Smith, 9% chance to make the shot. Well, 40's better than nothing. And the Pacers better than the Cavs by two in this one. They're up 2-1 in the series. Good daddy. Make sure, because she be coming now. I think she's sorry. She did. She said she did see me. Touch my sway. Granny, you standing right there, and I'm watching you. And I'm finna get Teddy on her. Don't laugh at me. Oh, no. I think we might have to start over the game. We're gonna have to start over the game. Y'all, we're gonna have to start over this game.
58-35. This was over early. Bucks up a couple touchdowns. A great three over Aaron Baines. Giannis had 19. Middleton went all scores from 23.
All right, so guys, we're gonna go back on Granny.
but he was out of his game early. This game was
because we had messed up and I was supposed to go ahead and go through that secret door. Alright, y'all. So we needed to start all over. I'm sorry, but we needed to. I mean, we can't just start over the whole thing. Oh, we have to check in here first. Always check in here before you leave. Don't check in the other one because it doesn't make any sense. We're at the basement now. It says, this is my fifth day in this house. She chases me whenever, wherever I go. I'm quiet, injured, and my body hurts. The only thing I remember before I woke up in this house is that I was driving when my car suddenly broke down. I went to see what was the problem when somebody suddenly hit me in the head. I have managed to open a pair of locks on the front door, but that's all. Why does she do this? I hope no one will experience the same thing as I do. I hope. If I do not survive this and somebody finds this message, I have noticed that she sometimes hides things in fruits. Well, that's dumb. Why would she hide things in fruits? I'm gonna keep dropping. I can throw it at you. Read that note, Granny. Can she read that?
Six innings, nine Ks for Scherzer. Four hits, five two nets.
Finish your surroundings. Finish your surroundings. Read this, Granny.
Strikeouts, but just
Bye, old lady.
Some positives, but the end of the day, just not enough good pitches in front of the scoring position to get out of the jam. And when you're going against Max, it's gonna be tough.
First up, balls are 1-3. Scherzer's 4-1. This is the third time these two started against each other. Scherzer's had an edge in strikeouts, as this was the second time in those three starts that he had at least 5 more strikeouts than Kershaw. All other pitchers have done so 5 times against Kershaw, but Scherzer, the only one to do it twice. Bradley Beal said the Wizards came out with an edge for Game 3 against the Raptors, and they needed it because Toronto had a 2-game edge in the series. Highlights coming up from a game that got physical in D.C. Friday night. Whether you're painting your home,
Why is she chuckling like that? Why is she chuckling like that? Like, get up. We found the wind chandle. What we need to do is to get this. Teddy! Be quiet. This is my heart. I'm gonna go here, get the hammer, the wind chandle. Me gonna put this right in front. She right there. Here's Teddy Graham, Granny. She get me, bro. How does she get me? Who's that? What day is this anyway? Put my faith on Granny. I'm evil. Ha! She laughs like my friend Corinne, bro. No. No, I cannot do anything with that. Stand right there, but she didn't even see me though. Now that's reality TV. I won't move until I. Maybe that. That was a bit missed
opportunity. Certainly for the junior from Fargo, North Dakota. The NCAA Women's Gymnastics Championship continues today with semifinal number 2. at 7 Eastern on ESPNU. For more information on the 9th NCAA Championship, follow on NCAA.com. Sarah Schaefer now for Arkansas on 4. Scores in for Michaela Burton.
It's time that nobody's waiting. Come on, Granny. This is what's gonna happen to you.
The phone staying all plays a lot of credit to our other three guys out there. This is being a big help position. Also just trying to play out the shooting for the first two games. We would be in help position to give those guys warm-up shots and get to knock them down tonight. They made some tough ones early on, but it was just stuck with the coverages and the changes we made.
Looking more closely at the numbers, Wall and Beal, the difference is they each had 28 points. Washington outscored the Raptors by 12 points a game, compared to those two on the floor. In the first two games of the series, the Wizards were outscored by 28 points when both guards were on the floor.
Come on, honey. Shot A.
Vegas is the best team story in these cup playoffs. Colorado's Andrew Hammond has to be the best individual story.
Tranquilizer? Hang on, I'm gonna tranquilize her again. I'm only on day three, y'all. I'm only on day three. So it's alright, I only have two more days. If I get the perfect piece, I get the opportunity to get that. That is what he's holding. Guess what? Granny gonna win. Because I'ma summon her. That's right. I'ma go downstairs, get my teddy bear. And this is what I'm gonna do, honey. Wait, first I got to get the tranquilizing dart, first of all. This is hard, y'all. This is real hard.
Could this be how Is it possible that the Balmaster machine described in the Vedic texts was really a technological device that existed on Earth thousands of years ago? Ancient astronaut theorists say yes, but suggest it was used not to build Kailash
from
the top down, as mainstream scholars propose, but carved out the structure from the bottom up.
One of the more mysterious aspects of the site of Allura are the tunnels that seem to go nowhere at the site. Some of them turn at odd angles, some go as deep as
get that feet. Teddy up in that crib, summon her. Like, psh. Then I won the game.
You can see that the local authorities have fenced this off. But if you look through this hole, you can see that this tunnel goes vertically down. Local authorities believe
that tunnels like these lead to a vast underground city under Kailasa Temple.
What could be the purpose for these tunnels below Kailasha Temple? And why are they fenced off from the public? In 1876, renowned English spiritualist Emma Harnish Britton published Ghostland, in which she writes of hidden tunnels beneath the Ellora Caves and the meetings of a secret cabal of mystics in an underground city. Britton tells of spiritually contacting a mysterious figure named Cavalier Louis, who witnessed the clandestine society.
Cavalier Louis states that he was taken into the side of Ellora, where he was led through a secret passageway into an underground chamber. The underground chamber opened up into a huge amphitheater, and there were these wondrous metallic thrones that were being charged with powerful galvanic batteries that rose up into the air. And seated on these thrones were seven mysterious hooded figures. But the most interesting one was the one in the center, who spoke and yet was not always there. His body shimmered in and out of physical space and time.
But why would vast rooms and tunnels exist deep underground beneath Kailasha Temple? Ancient astronaut theorists suggest
why am I walking like this
could be further evidence that Lord Shiva has a connection.
I'm sorry if I wasn't talking so long. I'm sorry, I have to focus on this game.
We have a great deluge that changed the face of the earth and forced people.
Because I have to try to summon her and everything, you know.
So you have to wonder, is this some kind of ancient city, many thousands of years old, that was once some kind of extraterrestrial base? And as the water receded, they create this temple from underground. Presently, archaeologists date the Kailasa Temple from the 5th to the 10th century AD, but there's nothing in the temple that really gives it a date. And in fact, like many things in ancient India and around the world, these temples may be much, much older than the mainstream archaeologists are saying.
This is a long playing game.
Could it be that hidden beneath Kailasha Temple is an underground alien city? And if so, would this prove that the being Hindus call Shiva was really an extraterrestrial visitor who gave technology to an earlier race of humans and ultimately destroyed them? Perhaps further clues can be found by examining a sacred icon believed to hold extraordinary power. Coming up.
The Shiva Linga stone actually can be the force for incredible destruction.
We're dealing with some kind of the cosmic power that we didn't fully understand until the discovery of nuclear fission.
AlienCon is back. Landing June 15th through the 17th. 2018 at the Pasadena Convention Center. Join us to explore the unexplained mysteries of the universe.
Remove all the false information,
including expert panels and autograph signings with Giorgio Tsoukalos and all your favorite ancient aliens contributors.
I'm getting goosebumps just thinking about it.
AlienCon, June 15th through the 17th. Get tickets now at thealiencon.com.
Time to go.
Alexa, start my Infinity QX50.
I'm at the crib, and I'm finna drop it in there. Watch this, some men. Oh, hang on. What's this? Watch this, some men.
The all-new Infinity QX50. Super.
That's four. Come down. Watch this, some men.
Mm-hmm.
here's something you should know. There's a serious virus out there that 1 in 30 boomers has, yet most don't even know it. A virus that's been almost forgotten. It's hepatitis C. Hep C can hide in the body for years without symptoms. Left untreated, it can lead to liver damage, even liver cancer. The only way to know if you have Hep C is to ask your healthcare provider for the simple blood test. If you have Hep C, it can be cured. For us, it's time to get tested. It's the only way to know for sure.
Booking a flight at the last minute doesn't have to be expensive. Just go to Priceline. It's the best place to book a flight a few days before my trip and still save up to 40%. Just tap and go. For the best savings on flights, go to Priceline.
Experience a world of extraordinary power. It's Steel Dealer Days. Get legendary steel quality. And save now on the MS-170 chainsaw. Remember, steel products are only sold by steel dealers. Steel Dealer Days are happening now. Search STIHL or visit steeldealer.com.
Her eyes have turned red. It hurt me. Ah, it hurt me. It hurt it me. It hurts. I'm sorry, Granny. Not just another beer. You got my heart beating. I'm so sorry. I didn't mean for that to happen. I'm so sorry, Granny. I'm sorry, my heart is beating so bad, bro. Y'all can even hear it.
We know you love it, so get more of it with Applebee's new, bigger, bolder grill combos. Now that's eating good in the neighborhood.
Searcy, India. 10 miles outside of this city, in the southwestern state of Karnataka,
I feel bad for
within
them.
The river Chamala, is one of the country's most popular pilgrimage sites, Sahasralinga.
Oh, gosh. I'm still going to put that bear in the crib. You still going to put that teddy bear in the crib? You think I'm going to cry over that? That was a prank.
These sacred idols are representations of the
Granny, I'm still going to put that teddy bear in the crib. You know that.
Thousands of pilgrims once
and I don't care. I don't care if it's from Juno's grandmother.
Mahashivaratri is a festival where Shiva is worshipped for his great nature. Mahashivaratri is usually held in the end of February or beginning of March. During that month, the water
you're smart,
level
Granny.
Of the Salmala River drops down so that all the Shivalingas are exposed.
Shiva's depicted as a Shivalinga, this kind of a spherical column, the flaming pillar that is the cosmic axis of the universe. Every Shivalinga that's in worship is set into a yoni. This is a special base, and it actually serves kind of a utility, a function. It's a spout, but when you pour offerings over the surface of the linga, they wash over the sacred body. Images of Shivalinga are found throughout Southeast Asia, even in parts of East Asia. Sometimes images of Shiva as a lingam also made its way into China and into Japan.
The Shivalinga first appeared over 2,000 years ago, and there is still debate over what this shape was originally meant to symbolize. But ancient astronaut theorists suggest that the uncommon...
What did I do to you, Granny? Ooh, I don't care. What?
Paris, France, 1900. At the Paris Congress of History of Religions, Swami Vivekananda, a scientist and monk credited with popularizing Hinduism in the West, gives a lecture addressing the meaning of the Shivalinga. For centuries, Western scholars have assumed the Shivalinga has purely a sexual connotation. The cylinder is the male phallic symbol and the yoni is the complementary female symbol.
And in 1900, the Hindu scholar
Google random things.
Deliver a major lecture about Hinduism and symbolism.
I don't care about Granny.
During this lecture,
and she don't care about us, so we can't care about her.
The coming in or going out.
That's a fact. That's a big fact.
It stands for energy, and it has often been misrepresented in the West that it is simply a phallic symbol of Shiva, which is not the case. It is obviously a pillar. Linga means a pillar.
Modern Hindu scholars have theorized that the Shiva Linga stone actually represents atomic energy. When we think about this idea of what atomic energy can do, how it can be used for good, but it can be extraordinarily destructive, this certainly pertains to the mythology of Shiva, who is chaotic energy, who is a force for incredible good, but also a force for incredible destruction.
Newbie.
Is it possible that this symbol of Shiva's power actually represents atomic energy? Ancient astronaut theorists say yes, and suggest the proof can be found by examining this mysterious shape.
The cylindrical structure of the Shivalinga is similar, or almost identical, to a modern-day nuclear reactor. And the groove that surrounds the base represents the structure's bulk to dispose of the polluted water. In ancient times, and even today, Hindus pour water or milk on top of Shivalinga as a ritual. Today, we pour water over the top of a nuclear reactor to cool it. And interestingly, most Shiva temples are always found near water bodies, like rivers or lakes, just like nuclear power plants. So, is it possible that Shivalinga actually represents an ancient nuclear power plant?
In the story of Shiva,
oh gosh, my back hurts.
Dealing with some kind of a universal or cosmic power that we didn't
she had
not understand until the 20th century, with the discovery of nuclear power.
You think I would actually cry over
these discoveries that predate modern man are completely changing our conception of the ancient past and connecting us to the true history of humanity, all before the time of the flood. Does the Shivalinga symbolize an extraterrestrial technology that existed on Earth before the Great Flood? Could it be a message left for us by our ancestors that an advanced society of humans existed long ago and suffered a terrible fate? Perhaps further clues can be found.
Well, goodbye, y'all. All I just wanted to do was just put the teddy bear in the crib. That's all I wanted to do. So, later.